You have led us to a new age, Guardian. An age of triumph and remembrance. We thank you, Guardian, and we will never forget.
Hello, and welcome to a Bungie live stream. We are here today to reveal Age of Triumph, the next live event that is coming to Destiny. I am Deej. I will be your host for this reveal. And on the hot seat, we have two of the designers, two of the creators who have brought this event to life, who have conceived and built this celebration from an idea to a playable reality that we'll be deploying to you at the end of the month. So allow me to reintroduce you to Ryan Parody.
Hi.
Morning.
Good morning, Deej.
And Joe Blackburn.
Hey, everybody.
So before we begin, before we dive into the details, for members of our audience who might not have seen you on stream before, I'd like to introduce you to them, reintroduce you to them, perhaps, and have you tell our audience why they should listen to you. Tell them what you do at Bungie and what hand you had in creating Age of Triumph.
Sure. So I'm Ryan Parody, lead designer on the live team, and I get to poke around in all the little live releases we ship to you guys. In Age of Triumph, I wore a lot of different hats. Currently, I'm doing some UI work, so there we go.
Okay. Cool. So obviously, you know, the live team keeps the world of Destiny feeling alive, gives players different things to celebrate, different reasons to return to the world of the game and play. What, in your own personal opinion, has been your favorite event, your favorite celebration in the world of Destiny?
So my favorite live event, my favorite celebration to date has been the Taken Spring.
The Taken Spring.
Yes.
Surely you mean the April update.
Yeah. Yes, the April update, but I do want to give a shout out to the community for coming up with Taken Spring. That's we can't claim that at all.
There are times we wish we were as clever as our community.
Exactly.
Okay. Joe Blackburn.
Hey.
Morning.
Morning.
Glad to have you back on the couch. For members of our audience who were not in attendance when we did our Wrath of the Machine raid-along, tell them what you do at Bungie.
I'm a raid designer. I work with the raid team on making some of my favorite content that Destiny has to offer.
Okay.
And
we're going to see some of that content redesigned and redeployed in Age of Triumph.
Yes. We're super happy to announce that all of the raids are coming up to light level in Age of Triumph.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So we're going to just talk about how all of that will work. It's important to note that Age of Triumph is not just about answering that very frequent piece of community feedback that has said, bring back the old raids. We have created a celebration of everything that has made Destiny a wonderful experience for players that they can share together over the past 3 years. Talk to us a little bit about your goals for this celebration, for what Age of Triumph is, and talk to us about the themes that have motivated the creation and the development process.
Sure. So when we kicked off the Age of Triumph development, it was really important to us to look at the past 3 years of Destiny and celebrate everything we've done, everything we've released, everything Guardians have done to become legend, everything you guys have done. Like, this is our celebration of you. That was our central pillar for this release. So we're looking at all the content they've known and loved, how to bring that to some kind of final light level, and just let them have fun with it. Let them re-engage with it, celebrate, complete their legend. Those were our goals for this.
It should be said that this is the very last live event that we will see as part of our Destiny 1 era adventure. Single tier.
Single tier.
So as our community is poised on this precipice, thinking about going to new worlds to experience new stories, this is their victory lap.
That's correct. The live team's had a great time working in the Destiny world. There's a lot to celebrate there. There's a lot for Guardians to do. We've shipped an awful lot of content from Destiny. Dark Below, House of Wolves, Rise of Iron, SRL.
Sparrow Racing League. This is my medal that I awarded to myself for being the grand champion of the Sparrow Racing League.
Deej won SRL.
Yeah.
Did happen.
Yeah, that's what happens when you control the content management systems that we would use to make those announcements.
So yeah, there's an awful lot in our universe to celebrate. There's an awful lot that players have done, and we wanted to kind of recognize them for all of that and give them some more goals to pursue to finish out their legend.
So similar to Sparrow Racing League, we're able to take a lot of inspiration from the community. So when they say, hey, I want to race sparrows, instead of just plotting waypoints across the wild frontier, you created a cultural event. You created something the city could celebrate. And similar to bringing back the old raids, you've created something that any guardian can use to celebrate the fun they've had with their friends or as a solo warrior out in Cosmodrome or beyond, on Earth or beyond, as the speaker would say. And we're going to take a look at exactly how all of that's going to work. This is the culmination of your adventure. And how exactly are you going to, what structure are you going to create to take people through that experience?
So to guide players through concluding their legend in Destiny, we've built the biggest record book we have to date. That is their way to celebrate, way to mark down all of their achievements in Destiny.
All right, well, let's take a look at the biggest record book we have ever created. Yep. To do this, we will join this Guardian live in orbit. Actually, we're not live, we're in the development environment. And what we've done for the purposes of today's stream is we have taken Joe Blackburn's Guardian and we have imported it into the development environment. So check out this golden warrior right here.
Yeah, I'm wearing my tower bling set.
Yeah, you are quite the vision here. And
Guardian.
The best part is because this is the development environment, I can just sort of, I can do whatever I want.
It's still painful. It still hurts.
Oh, look at this. I so wish this was Pope Bear. Just imagine. Anyway, that's enough fantasy and role play for right now. Where can I find the biggest record book that you've ever put in the hands of the Guardians?
Sure, so head over to your progress tab.
There we go.
And the Age of Triumph record book will have the little exclamation point there. It's the blue and yellow one.
There you go, okay. So the record book for Age of Triumph, this book is the companion to the Age of Triumph. Celebrate your victories against the darkness and write a record of your triumphs in light. And we have yet to begin, so we start at rank one.
Correct.
Learn to crawl before you can sprint.
Right. The record book will start at rank one for everyone.
Okay. And I see four items there. What are those?
So those will fill in with the records that we think stand out. They're like the records you've made progress in. Since you haven't cracked the book open yet, you don't really have any progress marked yet.
Yeah. So those are placeholders. When we begin, we'll see sort of calls to action, you know?
Exactly.
Here's what you're trending on. Jump back into the action and make some progress.
Correct.
All right. Well, let's take a look. So at a glance, I think the first things that our community would call out, the design of the Age of Triumph crest is full of clues as to what we're going to experience. Shout out to Unknown Player, who I saw tweeting on the day that we first previewed this, for noticing that all four of the raids are included in this crest right here. We've been teasing Vault of Glass because for the Destiny Raider, that's their origin story. We've got ways to honor all of the classes. And if you look down at this iconography, you see some call outs to the moments of triumph.
Right. This is your moments of triumph for all of Destiny, as it were.
Not just a moment, but an entire age. Record and celebrate your victories. We're going to break the seal. Ready? Here we go. Confidence is high. We're looking through the keyhole.
You can't return it now.
And there we go. So first thing to call out, 13 pages.
Right.
So
like
there
I said,
you go.
This is the biggest record book we've ever created. And it has 3 years of Destiny to celebrate.
You weren't kidding.
A novella of triumph, if you will.
There we go.
A novella. Not just old raids, but things to honor every type of player in Destiny. We will talk about what's on this page a little bit towards the end. Obviously, when you make progress through your record book, you earn rewards. You complete these milestones to rank up. But let's page through and let's see what you have in store for the people in our community. On every page, you're going to find a title. This is the commemoration page. You've walked a long road full of deeds and adventures. So what's the theme of this page?
So this is marking the players who were with us when. Mm-hmm. Like if you say, like, I've been there since day one, we have a record right there marking, like, yeah, you were playing during that time period.
From the
beginning.
We know
you were there.
Yep. Complete an activity between the Destiny release and the Dark Below release. So essentially, September, October, and November of 2014. Right. We see a lot of forum chatter that begins with day one Guardian here, you know, being there first, seniority, you know, that's important things to our community, and now we actually have a record book item to mark that.
Right, so you complete that, you were actually there in the first 3 months, you get record book XP and an emblem to mark, like, yep, I was definitely there, so other players will know.
Now, I want to say, before we go through all this, to alleviate whatever pain people might be feeling, this record book has been designed to honor every type of player. I said that several times now, but one thing I want you to tell our audience, do you have to complete the entire record book to stand out, to be able to display the rewards that are awesome in it?
So no, and like you just mentioned, like, we want every type of player to engage in this. So if you're a raider, there's things in here for you. There's ways for you to stand out. If you're a collector, there's ways for you to stand out. Mm-hmm. Like, there's something for everyone in this book.
Okay. We should mention, right, that this is a test environment, and if this was a live world, most of these would be filled in, right, because you'd logged in. These are things from day one that you get to access.
Right. Okay. So test guy here doesn't have any progress on this page.
Okay.
But like Joe, for example, might have the first four nodes already filled in because he was there. If you weren't there during one of these, you won't have that credit already.
So we've seen, you know, in other record books, especially Moment of Triumph, we've seen people log in and on the very first day say, oh, I did everything. Right. I guess there's nothing new for me to do here aside from to gloat. So with this record book, do you foresee anybody being completely done and ready to go on day one?
Absolutely not.
No.
So you will be less than halfway done with the book if you've been with us throughout the whole 3 years and you've done everything in Destiny. There's still goals for you to finish out your legend.
Yeah.
There are goalposts down the ways for you to hit still.
There are certain things that you're not even going to start tracking until they uncrack.
Exactly.
The rest. Okay.
So you'll get some of these key milestones, like, oh, you've been with us through the story from the beginning, or you've been to the lighthouse, let's say. We mark that.
So there we go. Here we go on the story page. And based on the character history that we imported from Joe Blackburn's character, this is not the name of Joe Blackburn's character. We're in the development environment, so anybody who's sending friend requests on the PlayStation Network, please stop. You're never going to meet Moves a Needle. He belongs to us. But your character, this clone of your character, has played a fair amount of story.
Yeah. And I'd love to, we can go through and sort of complete these and see how the page reacts to completing these records.
Yeah, why don't you mark those as complete as
okay.
you go through?
Here we go. Prepare to screenshot. We're going to show you some of these nodes, but certainly not all. And I'm earning XP for doing these things. And now I'm noticing that in the lower right-hand corner, there's a full page accolade here that we're tracking towards. And here we go, I've earned a reward. What are you giving them here?
So we have a lot of pages that are set up like this, where we have some records that ask you to complete some milestones.
Mm-hmm.
And then the eighth record is kind of your all-in-one, hey, you finished this page. So in this case, you've just gotten an emblem for being a standout story completer within Destiny. You have beaten all the stories. You've gotten the Tale Told emblem.
Mm-hmm.
So that now you stand out as that kind of guardian.
So on the first day, and let's just go on record, what is the first day of Age of Triumph?
First day is Tuesday, March 28th.
Okay. Detectives in our community probably could have figured that out. That is the only Tuesday when we tend to deploy new content after the last stream and before the end of March, which is when we said this would come out. So March 28th, mark your calendars. There will be a guardian in the tower who has played every story mission that we've thrown at you. It could be you. And you will have this emblem to display to let people know that I have knocked down every combatant that Bungie has stood up in my path. And we thank you for it. All right, so let's jump back into the record book. Come on now. I almost deleted it there. Wouldn't that have been awesome? Wouldn't that have been awesome? So we've seen this page. Back to the story page.
Mm-hmm.
We've unlocked, completed everything, and collected our reward. Moving right along to
a
Titan specific page. The Titan is a force multiplayer, a bulwark against the darkness. So you have achieved level 40 as a Titan. And rank up. So you're giving people XP. Go ahead.
Sorry, so right away you get to claim the, Joe's character is level 40, so we gave him progress for that. But there's still plenty of milestones here for Joe to hit down the road.
Okay. So we're highlighting some of these so that you can screenshot them, you can speculate, you can start to take a look at the volume and the scope of the record book, but we're going to leave some of these things for you to discover on your own. We want the first day of Age of Triumph to also be a day of discovery. So on this stream, we're not going to be comprehensive. We're not going to be completionist in the information that we provide. Moving right along, I'm going to guess that you also created a hunter page and a warlock page.
We did.
By knife, by smoke, by blink, strike, and stealth, a hunter stalks her prey.
What you can see here is Joe does not play a hunter.
Nope.
I think I just haven't logged on to my hunter in this environment.
Okay. So we have sort of recurring themes here. Use your melees, use your supers, and then complete quests.
The Crucible quests.
And then moving right along, this page will be near and dear to my heart, a warlock's path. There is no end to knowledge nor to power, but you'll do your best to reach it regardless. Don't I know it, brothers and sisters? So reach level 40, call them out for me, Ryan.
Defeat enemies with melee kills, or melee. Use your super to kill enemies, and the Warlock Crucible quests.
Nice.
These were the milestones that really made the classes stand out.
Now, does every page have one of those, full page rewards, where once you unlock every node on this page, there's the final reward that you claim?
A lot of them do. The commemoration page stands out in that you will get an emblem for each part of Destiny you were with us on the journey for.
Yeah, okay. Strikes.
Ooh.
Execute Vanguard strikes to secure your legend. So talk to us about these.
So right, this is basically gameplay throughout our whole strike ecosystem. So right away, this is heroic strikes here. Mm-hmm. We're gonna ask you to complete a Nightfall super quick, 30-minute timer. Precision kills and strikes.
500 of them. 500 precision kills in one strike, or 500 precision kills across?
No, in strikes in general.
Okay.
We're not mean.
Just standing here waiting for them to respawn and respawn. Okay.
And reviving allies in Nightfall strikes.
There you go. All right, so this is page 7 of 13. Mm-hmm. We're only just a little bit more than halfway through this. And the next page,
the Crucible.
Mm. Page dedicated to just the Crucible, just not the Crucible. Trials of Osiris, Crucible.
Reprise your feats and enshrine your legend in the Crucible.
Talk to me.
Playing some control Crucible matches there. Capturing points is going to be critical. Getting some rumble points. These are things that you'll have to do after launch day.
Watch your back. No one else will.
Finding all the dead ghosts we put on the maps in private matches. We're not mean. You can do this in a low-pressure environment.
Get in the game! I need this ghost! It's Age of
Where's
Triumph, man!
And then just winning matches in the Crucible. So the others you'll likely do while you're completing this one.
Yeah.
While you're winning matches, you'll probably get some rumble points.
Okay. And we'll leave the rest for...
I hope.
That's the idea. That's the dream. So that's page 8 of 13. Moving on to page 9 of 13,
oh,
Joe.
I love this page.
Yes, a page just for raids. When 6 guardians take up arms and storm the darkness, what can stand against them?
Nothing.
Hopefully.
So one thing we're really excited about on the raids team is to have this sort of culmination of all the raids content and a way to show off and prove that, you know what, I've done everything there is to do in raids. Mm-hmm. So you'll see not only do we have records for beating all the reprise raids at 390 Light. We also have a record that's get every challenge mode emblem. And if you see, I've only got 5 and 9. That's because I haven't done the 4 new challenges that are coming out with Age of Triumph.
So we'll talk about the approach to adding some new design elements to these raids at the end of the stream. But just to summarize real quickly, you've added challenge modes to all 4 of the raids. So you have challenge modes for all 4 of the raids. You added them where they didn't exist.
Correct.
Okay, cool. I also see that these raids are now at 390 light.
They are at 390 light. So every raid that is coming back is coming back at 390. This is at parity with Wrath of the Machine hard mode.
You mean like Ryan parity?
Just
exactly
like Ryan parity.
You mean equality.
Correct.
So all raids are an equal experience now. All a relevant step that you can take in your path to reaching maximum light of 400.
That is correct.
Okay. This obviously begs the question, are we raising the light level in Age of Triumph?
So we're not raising the light level for Age of Triumph, and the reason being for that is to touch back on our core pillar of this is a celebration of your guardian. This mm-hmm. is your victory lap, as it were.
Okay.
Raising the light level would be neat, sure, but what it does is it just moves the chain for our players, and yeah. we didn't want to feel like, hey, we're just moving the chain on you, now get to this new light level, mm-hmm. make it harder for players who haven't hit 400 already. Like, yeah. oh, why are you just moving this on me? No. We want you to play the activities you know and love. Yeah. We've freshened them up quite a bit. Prison of Elders, heroic story missions. Mm-hmm. Like, you'll have chances to play all these activities to get to the conclusion of your legend.
So a player who is not yet at 400 light, who really wants to do that before they finish their Destiny 1 adventure, you have a whole new set of rituals that will help them get there. The raids are part of that.
Exactly. So like you said, we have the rituals to help you get there. We wanted to be generous with getting players to endgame light levels.
So we're uniting
the community. They've experienced Destiny.
Yeah, yeah. And we're uniting the community at the finish line.
Exactly.
Everybody gets to cross the finish line. Everybody gets to take that victory lap. They get to enjoy that culmination of their adventure. And for a guardian who is 400 light, who would say, what's the point? What would you say to them?
Yeah, so I think I was one of the people that when we were initially talking about not mm-hmm. doing a light bump, I was like, oh, no, I've got 400 everything. Like, what's this update going to do for me? And the real interesting part is, you know, when you're playing this update, the thrill is getting these rewards and having them be 400 right away, mm-hmm. right? When I get my year 2 Mythoclast, it comes in hot, right? It comes in at 400 and I can just equip it.
So it's an
play
option.
With it. Yeah.
It's not infusion fuel.
Yeah, I don't have to look at all these things that I've collected and be like, all right, which one do I want to infuse to make the other yeah. one better, yeah. right? I get it, I use it.
Okay. So you said Mythoclast, and I'm sure our chat is going to go crazy. Mythoclast has always been a popular weapon. At this point in time, you may want me to open a character and start showing all of the rewards that you're going to get, all of the armor ornaments that you're going to be able to use to decorate your guardian, all of the raid weapons that have been icons in and of themselves that we're going to add back into the sandbox. This is going to be a very detailed conversation. I'm going to kick that can 2 weeks down the road because for the third and final stream in this series about Age of Triumph, we're going to have Josh Hamrick back on the hot seat, and Josh is going to talk all about how this will impact the sandbox, elemental primaries from the Vault of Glass, how that will impact the sandbox, how having Vex Mythoclast back will impact the Crucible. Oh, the nightmare and terror that created in Destiny Year 1. But for now, we are going to stay on target, talk about this record book, and talk about those raids. And the 10th page of 13 is all about collecting. Gather the riches and wonders of the star system.
Right, so this is the page wherein we wanted to highlight the collectors of Destiny, the people who are going around collecting every ship, mm-hmm. every shader, every ghost. Like, we wanted these people to have their own special call out in the record book. It's also important to note here that none of the things we're asking you to collect are things that you won't find on your kiosk.
Okay.
I also think it's really interesting that even if you look at like the record I have at the top, that I have 38 of 75, there are more than 75 ships.
Ah, okay.
Right.
So if you're like a Rise of Banker or Rise of Bacon style Redditor that's been going after your Nano Phoenix for 50 attempts, right?
Yeah.
Don't worry, you can still get this one as long as you've collected most. And if you're like me and halfway through, you should be monitoring what ships they're selling today.
Yeah.
So you can start yeah. collecting those and getting
exactly.
a leg up on your Age of Triumph.
And if somebody's thinking right now, oh my God, I'm never going to get there because I had these things and I deleted them, you're going to be able to go to all of the kiosks in the tower and pull these things back out. The game will sense that and give you credit.
Right. Just go to your kiosk, pull it out. We'll give you credit for
okay.
it.
Okay. Okay. That's thank you. Thank you for thank you for thinking in such a fashion. On behalf of a grateful community, I thank you. The Wanderer, you have gone far, seen much, and heard echoes of the past. What are we tracking here?
So these are the explorers of Destiny, the people who have found all of our little hidden secrets, like the dead ghosts here. Not every dead ghost in the game, but a majority of them. Some of the dormant Siva here. Mm-hmm. Joe's got about half.
I bet I'm getting a lot of flack for not collecting those other 13.
Hey, man, you're busy killing. You're busy killing.
I got the Galahorn.
Yeah, exactly.
Playing in our public spaces, doing some public events.
Yep.
And then disturbing the remains.
A million deaths are not enough. I think every time we introduce new content, every time we welcome new players to our community, it's always precious when somebody goes to their favorite internet forum and said, I found some bones and it whispered at me about someone named Rahul. And everybody goes, oh, who wants to tell them?
The kindergartens.
Yes, we love them. New recruits are the lifeblood of any community. So never, ever, ever be ashamed about asking what somebody else might tell you is a stupid question. Because there's no such thing. There's never such a thing. Allegiances, fealty and favor, honor and respect, all are yours to earn.
So these are the call-outs for players who have gone to all of the factions, the Vanguard, the Cryptarch, and leveled up with all of them for the reputation packages.
Gotcha. Okay.
Each of these gets their own emblem, as you can see. So if you're high up with the Vanguard, cool, Vanguard emblem.
And are we starting to track this now, or will this be retroactive?
This is a page full of retroactive items.
Okay. So what we're looking at on this page is a product of, we imported Joe's character and it's just not behaving properly in the test environment. On day one, you'll probably see a lot of yellow circles here. So please do not be concerned that you have to go through and rank up 25 times with Dead Orbit. That's a lot of motes of light. That's a lot of bounties.
Or maybe Joe's just slacking with his
I think this character's just really lazy.
Yeah, exactly. I don't like anybody. I don't need any of you.
All right, and it looks as if here you have somebody who's just the big man on campus in the tower, right?
Yeah, if you've gone around the tower, if you're at high level with all of the factions, we want a special way to denote that kind of player.
Yep, someone who's loyal to no one. Someone who no one can fully trust. I think you got to pick a side, is what I'm saying. I think you know, I've declared fealty to Dead Orbit. And those of you out there who say, oh, I like all the factions, you're doing it wrong.
I really love those page cappers, because if you're a player like me who's just never going to join Dead Orbit, right? Like, I'm going to be walking around, hopefully, with my raid skull. And I'm like, this is what I'm about, right? I'm the raider. I finally have the raid skull emblem. Mm-hmm. It shows that, like, I've done all the raid things. But, you know, someone like Brenton may be like, no, I'm about factions. I'm about collecting ships. And they can show off that they've, like, spent a ton of time in Destiny.
This is one more opportunity for every player of the game to really indicate to the community, to their friends or the people who inspect them, this is what Destiny has meant to me.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
This is your opportunity to fly your colors to tell people who you are.
Cool, okay. And the final, the 13th luckiest page of the Record Book, Trials of Osiris. The lighthouse beckons, but the trials winnow. So here we go. There's going to be a lot of LFG going on. Like,
get me to the lighthouse.
So I want to call out with this record in particular, we have set this up so that if you've ever been to the lighthouse, we give you credit here for it.
Okay.
We're not asking you to, like, hey, if you got carried, go again. No, we're not that mean. If you've ever been, get some credit.
It's retroactive. Joe, have you been to the lighthouse?
I've just never been to the lighthouse.
You've never been to the lighthouse.
I've never been to the lighthouse.
Okay, I'm gonna introduce you to a guardian by the name of Anbu. If he can take me to the lighthouse, he can take you to the lighthouse.
All right.
My third was Pope Bear. You can take Pope along with you if you want.
I've gone one loss away.
Have you really?
I did that a few times with some people that were much better than me, but one day we'll make it.
All right, let's take a look at the other things that people need to do in Trials of Osiris.
So get the Wrecking Ball medal.
Well, that's fine. I'm sure I already had that. I probably did that and didn't even realize it.
Special weapon kills. We only ask you to get 30.
Okay.
And 25 revives.
Okay. That's so, my record.
As a good guardian does.
We call that the Joe record. So if you go to the bottom right here, it's very important to note on this page that we don't ask you to get all the milestones on this page to complete the page. We only ask you to get 6. And that's so if you've never been to the lighthouse, or you haven't gotten that Wrecking Ball medal, most people haven't, you can still finish this page.
Yeah. I can imagine the Crucible Elite would say to the community, the fact that I've done all of these things makes me truly special, but I get the impression that if somebody has invested that deeply in Trials of Osiris and they want to put an emblem up on their Guardian that says, this has been important to me, this has been my favorite thing to do. I've been there, I've been in that battle. On some occasions, I've laid down and died in your path so that you could reach the lighthouse. We want to honor those gamers too.
Exactly.
I think we still have the scarab, right? For the truly Trials of Osiris Elite, they'll always have that.
Yeah.
Oh, I won and kept going.
Yeah, they'll always have it in Destiny 1. And that is all 13 pages of the biggest record book you ever done created. I want to rewind here and page back through everything that we've looked at and come back to the very first page. And there's been an emerging theme here in the things that you've said. And I just want to call out here, complete milestones to rank up the record book. Completion is not required to claim all of the rewards.
That's correct. So we didn't make it so that you have to finish every single record, every single page in the record book to get all the rewards here. That's just not something that sounded fun to us. Like, most players aren't going to be excellent raiders and the best Trials of Osiris players. You know, there's some very difficult things to do in this record book. So we wanted to make sure that everyone was able to feel like they've completed their legend within the 3 years of Destiny.
Jack of all trades, master of a few, perhaps.
Exactly.
But the Age of Triumph record book is not for the master of all trades.
Sure. The thing you're passionate about, you will earn and you will stand out as that.
Okay.
But you can earn the record book rewards for just completing roughly 3/4 of the record book.
So Moves the Needle here has moved up to rank 2. So I'm going to claim this reward. And these emblems indicate progression through the record book. I get one per character, one. And we'll take a look at some of these. Hit rank 3, hit rank 4.
I love 4. That Miami Vice style emblem.
Yeah, pretty sweet vibes there.
Definitely got some 80s Art Deco at work there. And screenshot these emblems. Rank 5, and rank 6 is the last emblem that you're going to collect in this category.
It's the very sweet Age of Triumph kind of crest there.
Okay, and what happens when I reach rank 6?
So when you reach rank 6, you get that, and actually we've confirmed now you have to get to rank 7 to get your last reward.
Okay, so keep ranking up, and you've unlocked a personalized offer from the Bungie store. Visit bungie.net/triumphs to learn more. So there are people in our community who walk around wearing a shirt with this design on the front, indicating that they were legends in their moments of triumph, and they got a customized t-shirt to prove it.
That's correct.
You're doing that again?
We are doing that again. We are putting it in the game, so you know that when you hit rank 7 here, you have unlocked this thing. You will go to BungieNet, and you'll have your t-shirt offer.
Okay. And you can go to the Bungie store, and you can buy that shirt.
Right. And it won't be $700,000 for you.
No. It'll be a reasonable expense. Can you show us the shirt?
I can.
There you go. All right. Nice throw.
Let's see what we got.
Had to practice that a few times.
Just a few.
All right. So it is a shirt with the Age of Triumph crest. Beautiful, and you'll be able to.
Sleeve.
You'll be able to wear your prowess right there on your sleeve. Right now, it says your gamer tag here. If that's your gamer tag, let us know, and we'll send you that. That's your gamer tag or PSN ID.
Oh man, I need
ID.
To go get that.
They better show us their rank 7 book first.
Exactly. We're gonna need proof on that. So your PSN ID or your Xbox Live gamer tag can go right on the shirt, so that when you walk around in a place where you might discover other Guardians, people can be like. It's not a matter of hitting 100% in Destiny the game, but you have hit 100% in this record book, which is an indication that you played a lot of Destiny.
That's correct.
You played a lot of Destiny.
And one thing I do want to call out, which might have been obvious, and Joe kind of hinted at it, this record book is account scoped. So all the trials you've done on all of your Guardians will count towards this. It's not like, I have to go get my Titan and do trials. Go get my Hunter and do trials. No. These are all account scope. You do them one, you're done.
Okay. One and done across any number of 3 Guardians.
That's correct.
Okay. Even if you've been deleting Guardians along the way.
The only place you will not get credit for that would be your specific class-based pages. Okay. So if you had a hunter, you deleted him, well, we don't have that data anymore, so you should have a hunter.
Okay, okay. You know who deletes a lot of characters in Destiny? Pope Bear.
He should.
All right, so moving right along, we are going to take a look at these raids, Joe.
Oh, I'm excited.
These raids. So I'm going to take a look at my director. Actually, I'm going to take a look at your director. And as part of Age of Triumph, you have a whole suite of featured activities. The bottom left-hand corner of the director since the launch of Destiny has been come here and do special stuff. Come here and embrace the Destiny endgame. Looks like that's changed up a little bit. Next week, we are going to have Tim Williams and Joe Sifferman on the hot seat, and they're going to talk to us about how these weekly rituals are going to change a week in the life of a Guardian who is experiencing Age of Triumph. For the time being, talk to us about this, because this is a very notable new addition.
Yeah, so one thing that we've been excited about for a very long time and are very happy to get the chance to do it here is this idea of Raid of the Week, of the idea that you've got a team of your five friends that you want to play content with, and you're no longer playing the same raid over and over and over again because it's the only one that's an appropriate light level. We're introducing this concept of a weekly featured raid. Mm-hmm. So a featured raid means not only is it at 390 light, all the challenge modes are active.
Okay. So previously, you know, the raid that is current in the end game of Destiny had different challenge modes week over week over week. So different encounters were the featured difficult enhanced moment in that raid. We can see here that you have a Templar challenge and an Atheon challenge, and when Vault of Glass is the weekly featured raid, both of them will be active.
Always.
Making that's a tough raid.
That is a tough raid, and so what you get to do is, as your fire team, is decide, all right, well, we want to complete the featured raid because just completing the feature itself has some unique rewards.
Yeah.
Or maybe you guys are game enough for the Templar challenge, but you aren't game enough for the Atheon challenge, which we think is the hardest challenge that we've ever made.
Yeah. How do you beat Atheon now?
Very carefully.
Very carefully.
Very carefully.
They love us for answers like that. But raids are supposed to be the ultimate mystery, so you get a pass.
Yeah, and I think one thing that probably some people are worried about right now is, okay, well, I'm really excited about when it's Vault of Glass featured week, and I'm really excited about when it's Crota's End featured week. But what about King's Fall and Wrath?
Yeah.
I already played those raids, played them maybe recently, and I maybe have all those rewards leveled up. Well, there's new stuff coming down the pipe for you. We've worked together to sort of really come up with a system where no matter what the featured raid is, not only are you going after these cool ornaments, but there are unique rewards, and there's even some new rewards in some of these old raids. Some of you might realize that, hey, those old raids never had ghosts, and those new raids never had sparrows.
Oh, my. Okay. All right. So we got a question mark there. Raid set gear. If I have trophies in my vault, if I have my old Vault of Glass helmet that I always adored, and it's been collecting dust these past couple of years, am I going to be able to pull that out and infuse it and start using it right away, or am I going back into the vault to capture that again?
So we are coming out with a new Vault of Glass helmet. And one of the reasons I think you're going to be really excited about this new one is it has two master ornament skin slots.
Okay.
So there's lots of ways you can make your new gear coming out look real shiny.
And it's going to drop at, what are going to be the drops?
If you're 400,
drops.
It's dropping at 400.
Okay. Cool. So go in and enjoy those raids. I played the Vault of Glass during Destiny Year 1 a couple times. Got nothing but shards. But Destiny has become a kinder, gentler, more rewarding game. And how would you describe the investment mood with these raids coming back into prominence?
I can't use the tagline the live team uses, but it's generous as heck.
Generous as heck. Okay.
I was going to say frick.
Okay. Frick is a good word.
Whatever profane substitution frick you prefer, it's as generous as that. All right. So talk to me about the rollout schedule here. So we have this weekly featured raid activity. Who's up first? Is it Are we going to Venus to play the Vault of Glass?
Actually, we are not going to Venus first.
All right, where are we going first?
Week one, we are going to Crota's End. In the reprisal of Crota, we think we got to do a lot of exciting things to really make Crota shine. Mm-hmm. And we want Crota to come out week one with all these great new changes.
Okay.
And so one of the benefits of the rollout schedule is week one, Crota is going to be the featured raid, and it's also going to have come out with the 390 hard mode. When week two, when Vault of Glass comes out as the featured raid, you can still go back and play Crota's End 390 hard. It won't be featured, the challenge modes won't be on, but you can play that week if you want to.
Okay.
And then when week three hits and King's Fall becomes the featured raid, mm-hmm. You can go back, and if you want to raid a bunch, you can raid all of the raids that week at 390.
You just raid your ass off. Okay, so the rollout schedule, we're going to do one every week across the month of April.
Correct.
Beginning on
March 28th.
March 28th. So we begin with Crota, go in and see how Crota has been, you know, pulled apart and rebuilt. Then Vault of Glass. Then we come in on the third week, and we play King's Fall, and so, then your baby. Your Wrath of the Machine.
So if you look even here, we're in a setting where King's Fall hasn't been unlocked yet.
Yep.
So right now, he just has the 310 version. Those versions aren't going away. The 310 hard mode version will always be there. The 290 light version for normal mode will always be there.
But we're adding a new node.
Correct.
The Age of Triumph redesigned, reinvigorated mode will always be there with an opportunity to earn those rewards. Now, do the ornaments always drop or only when it's featured?
Featured is where you're going for your ornaments.
Okay, so you're looking for that weekly featured raid to get the best stuff out of these activities.
And you should be excited about this stream 3 weeks from now because there's more than just ornaments that are be coming out of those featureds.
Yep, okay, yep. We're going to talk all about the weapons. We're going to be talking all about the armor. And we will delve deep into that sandbox and show you why you fight. Okay. Well, I think that gives us a pretty good understanding of how all of this is going to work. You've got your weekly featured activities. If you're looking at these other icons right now, we're going to delve deeply into the details of how all of these will also play a role in Age of Triumph, how all of these other activities will also be a worthy step in your path to reach 400 light. We might even talk about how we're going to add a little bit more mayhem to strikes in terms of the Nightfall. But that will be a conversation for Joe Sifferman and Tim Williams to have. For the time being, I'm going to put down this controller, and we're going to let Cosmo and his raiding party pick up their controllers. We're going to join them live.
Exciting.
For a raid in progress. We now come to you live inside the Vault of Glass. Take a bow, gentlemen. So we have a raiding party all set up and ready to go here. And while they play, while they tackle the Age of Triumph Vault of Glass, talk to us about what you had said before. Like, when did you really start thinking it would be fun to do a director's cut of these raids?
Yeah, so I think even in just post King's Fall coming out, we'd sort of learned a lot and from the community really playing these and thought, man, we really think we could make these raids shine. And this idea of, we didn't want to change the raids. We didn't want to make them something they weren't ever. So this is, you're not going to find a Takeified Vault of Glass or a Sivified Crota's End.
There was some significant fear and angst there. A little bit of wringing of hands last weekend.
Our goal here was really to look at these experiences and say, how can we make them shine? So if you were one of the guardians that really like to stand up on a ledge and snipe some oracles, you might have to get a little closer this time around.
Okay. All right.
But we also think any time we made sort of a change in that direction, we tried to make a change in a way that we thought the encounter was going to be more fun and more player friendly. So also for these sort of pre-Templar encounters that they're in right now, we just cut a little of the time off. We said, you know what we really didn't enjoy in year one was spending 10 minutes on oracles, wiping on the last one and having to go back. So we've made them a little bit shorter. Mm-hmm. And that's sort of been our philosophy with all of these raids is going in and sort of looking at the fossil of Vault of Glass and taking a brush and brushing it off and saying, what's a little thing that we think would make this a little more enjoyable? Or where did we misstep a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the challenge for you guys. When you go back and touch this content again, these are deeply meaningful experiences that are very important to people in our community. And while they might say bring them back, they want you to bring them back for the reasons why they loved them. And while you might want to innovate and enhance, if you do something where somebody says this isn't the Vault of Glass anymore, you may have traveled a bridge too far.
Correct.
Was there anything that you pulled out of your design because you felt like you were sort of approaching that risk?
Yeah, I think at one point, even in the Vault of Glass, we looked at the big jumping puzzle and said, you know what? This team worked so hard on making this jumping puzzle, making these blocks appear, and everyone just jumps across the ledge. And there was a period where there was this big wind volume that would just knock you away from the ledge and say, no, get off the ledge. And we were playing it in playtests and saying, you know, this isn't what I love about Vault of Glass. I love that I can step on this block and jump all the way to the ledge and walk all the way across the ledge and then get hit off by Notch Boss at the end.
Yeah.
Right? That's part of what makes the experience great.
Yeah.
So we're looking forward to the community's reaction. And we know any little thing we tweak or don't tweak is going to have some heated debate. But know that we looked at this with a very loving hand.
Okay. Yeah. There was actually somebody in chat said, did Luke Smith mind you touching his baby?
Yeah, I think one thing that Luke Smith would have definitely jumped down my throat about is if we added another chest to the Vault of Glass.
Oh, God. You went there, huh?
I okay. promise that we have not touched the amount of chests in Vault of Glass. And I can even say that as someone who played Vault of Glass as a player and not as an employee, because I was in a period of time where I was working elsewhere, I didn't understand how many chests were in the Vault of Glass. I was really excited to crack this open and see how many chests were open in the Vault of Glass. To this day, I still don't know. I think there are two people in the world that know how many chests are in the Vault of Glass, and that's Luke Smith and Matt Beignet. They didn't even tell the other designers on the team when they were placing them
sure.
where they were.
Yeah.
So I think he's going to take that secret to his grave.
That was one of the most challenging things before the actual launch of Destiny was people saying, so talk to me about these raids. I was like, I don't know what to tell you about the raids. Six people will play them. They're going to be really hard. If I go any deeper than that, I'm going to be a marked man when I go back home. So, you know, the fact that we're showing the raid being played here is certainly closer than we've ever come to revealing raids before we go in. But people remember this place. We wanted to show, you know, that these bad guys are pretty bad again. Actually, give me some context as to why we didn't start this raid from the very beginning, because as dramatic as it would have been to open the door and to build the spire, why do we join them in progress?
Sure. One of the reasons that we went straight into Conflux is because the opening experience of Vault of Glass is in a public space.
Yep.
And our public spaces work in a way that we don't level up those Minotaurs. Because your friend or kindergarten that's, you know, level 12 running around Venus, we don't want to throw a 390 light Minotaur in his face.
Yeah.
What we really want is for him at level 12 to sort of be like, hey guys, I'm here, I'm level 20, I'm shooting some guys in the face, like I'm having fun. And so that's preserved. You're not going to really see in Vault of Glass the new exciting changes until you step foot into the door.
Yeah. That's always been one of the funniest things when you're starting the Vault of Glass and some kindergarten shows up, you know, and is like, I'm helping. Yes, you are. Sometimes teamwork is just giving them other people to shoot at. All right. It should also be said that Destiny 1 is a game that's not going away. Destiny 1 is a game that we fully intend to keep online for the foreseeable future. So people may be discovering the Vault of Glass for the very first time. They may be Eyes Up Guardian for the very first time in the months to come. And the fact that you're giving elite guardians, you know, masterclass guardians, something new to do is cool. But I'm also grateful, just from a community manager perspective, that if somebody does join our community, some of those core experiences are still intact for them.
Yes.
So good thinking there.
I think that these 400 light guardians are going to have real fun going back into raids like Crota's and Vault, especially within Crota's. You know, you experienced that raid when you were playing it where it was such a higher light delta than you were as a player. Mm-hmm. And now not only are you only able to go in and be a little above it, but you're able to go in with new swords and supers and things that you didn't have before.
Yeah.
And so even if we changed nothing at all, you'd have a totally different experience going in there.
So there's certain different degrees of evolution here when we take a look at all four of the raids. Vault of Glass has been given new challenge modes. Its light has been brought up to the current levels. You've got some new takes on weapon and armor with the ornaments and then the ways that they'll behave in the sandbox. Again, we'll let Josh Hamrick go on record about that. Crota's End has some essential fixes.
Crota's End even has some changes to normal mode.
Okay.
So we looked at some of the experiences that we really wanted to shine in Crota's End and said, well, if we really need to bring this out and want to make this super fun and super great, like, it's going to be a little bit more than dusting here, a little bit more than dusting with a brush.
Yeah.
But we absolutely came in mind with what is the core experience here, what do players really love about it,
yeah.
And we are not about making your experience in these raids more of a slog or more of like a, oh my gosh, they took Crota's End and added all these Kingsfall mechanics to it, right?
Yeah.
These are still the raids that you love.
But if you're a master raider, if somebody says, there's no way, I know everything there is to know about these old raids, I don't need to play them again.
You're going to be surprised.
Yeah, okay.
You're going to be a little bit surprised.
Okay.
If you're one of those people that comes out and reads the patch notes day
yes.
one,
okay.
one thing we should touch on is we were pretty vague in the raids patch notes. You're probably going to go in there and see some patch notes like, hey, all the old bosses works with 3 of Coins. And,
okay.
Hey, they moved a switch in Wrath of the Machine, so it was easier to complete that challenge mode. And that's it. And you're going to be like, that's all they did?
No.
We've been waiting this
that's
long?
That's not all you did.
No, we want you to be able to discover the changes and the specific things yep. that we sort of altered in these. So,
yeah. So it's kind of a departure from our usual aesthetic for the patch notes, but we do not want our patch notes to be a strategy guide.
Correct.
Strategy guide. So a lot of the work that's been done here will be obfuscated when Cosmo goes in to publish those notes. So, yeah, I'm glad you issued that disclaimer.
Yeah.
That slipped my mind. That was a really good thing that you and I talked about a couple days ago. And then when we're working on Kingsfall, Kingsfall had challenge modes.
Correct.
But Kingsfall is going to have new ornamental armor. Every raid is going to have new ornamental armor.
Every raid has new ornaments. They are spectacular. Even Wrath of the Machine, who already had one ornament, they got a second slot,
okay.
Which is new—a new way to cibify your armor sets. I don't want to spoil anything. I'm very excited for the community to get their eyes on these. And even aside from just adding ornaments and having those weapons come back for Kingsfall, Ryan and his team did some great looking at those loot tables for Kingsfall and sort of how complicated they were. And a lot of this has just had a path,
okay.
Our paths to make everything sort of up to our new standards, up to like our Generous's Frick guidelines.
Yeah, the investment team did do a lot of work to make the drops feel a little bit better throughout there. A little more rewarding, more generous.
Anything else you want to tell the community? Anything else you want to say to our audience about the fact that old raids are finally coming back?
I am very excited for you guys to crack these open. I'm excited to see your takes on these challenge modes.
Okay.
We'll be out there with you and looking for groups. So hope to play with some of you guys and earn these emblems together.
Okay. And Ryan, anything else you'd like to say just to kind of put a bow on everything that Age of Triumph will be?
Age of Triumph. One age, one triumph.
One age, one triumph.
Just keep in mind, this is a celebration of everything Destiny has had to offer. We're going to go into the rituals next week. And there's some other cool stuff going on there. So it's not just all raids.
No.
Although raids are the coup de grace.
Okay.
There's other things for you to experience.
No matter what type of guardian you are, we've got something for you to enjoy at this party. The culmination of your adventure.
I really hope so.
Okay. All right. Well, I mean, there's always somebody who...
There's got to be someone.
Yeah, there's always somebody who falls through the cracks. But we'll be glad to have you in the tower. Our raiding party has a raid to finish, so we're going to leave them to it. Age of Triumph begins March 28th.
Triumph.
Age of Triumph. One age, one triumph.
Yes, March 28th.
Begins March 28th. Okay. Well, I want to thank everybody who tuned into this live stream. Thank you so much for watching. Gentlemen, Thank you for being on the hot seat and talking to us in such great detail about what you've created.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having us.
Thank Twitch Master Scott and MC Pate for keeping the tech smooth throughout the show, as well as Jenny and Brittany for everything they do behind the scenes to make these moments, or these ages.
This age.
Easy for us. We'll give a shout out to our raiding party after the show so you can see who these brave warriors were. I'm Deej. It's been my pleasure to be your host. We'll be back next week to talk about a week in the life of a guardian as part of Age of Triumph. We'll be glad to have you back then. But before we leave this stream, check this out.
From the day your ghost woke you, your light has been our beacon. You defended this city from the worst the darkness sent against us. Atheon, Crota, Oryx, Axis. When you are called on, you will do it again. The city's children tell your story to each other. Pretending to be guardians, they grow braver and more powerful with each retelling. They are no longer afraid. You have shown them, and you have shown me, what it is to hope. You have led us to a new age, Guardian. An age of triumph and remembrance. Today and tomorrow and every day, you fight for us. You fight for the Traveler. You fight for those who fled here from 1,000 nations looking for refuge. We thank you, Guardian, and we will never forget.